Meet Mrs. Paul Harvey, the wife of the voice of Middle America, and learn what makes their relationship so special when Mike Lederman and Joanne Williams host Chicago's PM Magazine, Monday night at 7 on Channel 32.
Hello, Sid Snot here. Don't forget, playing your tranny loud annoys the neighbours. Another good one is emptying your rubbish over the fence. Or tying bricks to the cat. Or thumping little old lady.
The following program contains naughtiness. But before each naughty,
we interrupt the intro of this show a little earlier this week to bring you more show. Smaller intro, more middle, get it? Get off. You're interrupting my opening.
Your opening?
Who are you?
I'm me.
No, you're not.
I'm me.
You're me?
No, I'm me.
Don't be silly. That's me over there. Hi, me over here.
The movie at noon, Suzanne Plichette and James Ferrantino star in Wings of Fire.
Let's see how good you really are. My life against yours, okay?
I don't want to kill you, Taff.
Then at 2 on the big movie, Spencer Tracy and Lana Turner star in Cast Timberlane.
From now on your own. You're free.
Wings of Fire at noon, Cast Timberlane at 2, Sunday on Channel 32.
The Kenny Everett Show.
Hello! Spod here from the planet Flung. I'd like to introduce my old cosmic buddy, Captain Kremmen. He's not quite as butch as me, though. He can't do this. But I dare say he doesn't want to.
Hi, kids. Kremmen here. You remember last time, still marooned on the mud planet, I received a very important message from Earth.
I have my husband with me. He shares all my ideals and all my affection for you.
I suddenly felt an attack of Land of Hope and Gloriness. I rose to my full 6'8", turned to Narg, leader of the Mudmen, and spoke. How often do the Thargoids come to collect supplies of radioactive mud for their reactors?
There is a shuttle coming tomorrow.
How many guards are on board?
Only one, but he's heavily armed.
He's right, Captain.
Huh?
Those shuttle guards carry grunge bombs.
Grunge bombs, huh? Never fear. I have a plan. We sat around for the rest of the night, reviewing our situation, while the Mudmen had their evening meal. Deep-fried ribs of mud with mud dressing, followed by mud madeleine and mixed mud from the trolley.
Oh, Captain, I think I'm gonna be ill.
No, wait, Carla, don't go.
Why?
I have an idea. Listen.
Hey, that's terrific.
Oh, it was nothing. You should hear the one that goes... That night... We decided not to sleep in the cave, but to venture out on what I was sure was to be our last night in the mud mines. As we stepped out into the night, the stars came out in heavenly splendor. Carla snuggled up to my vast, hairy, heaving chest, and together we turned the darkness into cosmic bliss.
Why ever not? Stay tuned, space groovers, and dig part two of your sexy, silly stereo space serial in the Kenny Everett Video Show.
Hi, Wonder Tart here. That was Captain Kremmen co-starring that hoary old ratbag, Carla. I wouldn't say she's got big feet, but she kickstarts Boeings.
There she goes, and hopefully there she stays. While you were watching that terrific sketch, I had a call from the upper offices from Lord Thames. And he said to me, it's a great show, it's moving along like a train on heat, but there's no parts of the show where you actually slow down and get to know the audience and sort of cuddle up with the listeners. So I'm going to do that now. So come on up, we'll have a natter, eh? A bit closer. Hello. It's great here, isn't it? It's lovely to talk to you like this, because I'm,
You know, I've been wanting to natter with you since the beginning of the show, but they said, you know, be wacky, Ken. So, anyway, here we are. You all right?
Good.
I thought we might, you know, get more intimate, you know. Like, we could have perhaps lunch one day. Why don't you ring my secretary? Or maybe we could go out and see a show. Wait a minute, this is sounding expensive. Tell you what, let's go over to the other side of the studio and watch Elkie Brooks instead.
Pearl's a singer. She stands up always when she plays the piano.
Was part one, and wasn't it great? But wait till part two. It'll give you a lift. Get it?
The Everett Show.
So let's have fun.
And now, here's Kenny Everett.
Commercial time.
Are you thin? I used to be thin. Friends played the saber dance on my ribcage. I had to move around in the shower to get wet. That old one. Dogs buried me. Once I was even mugged by a stick insect. Then one day, a friend recommended
Bulko!
If you're thin and rather flat, skinny as a mangy cat, we can take good care of that. Bulko shows you where you're at, and that's fat.
Bulko is a simple, easy-to-take routine of tablets. In only 2 weeks, you'll have a tablet like this.
If you're thin and rather flat, skinny as a mangy cat, we can take good care of that. Bulko shows you where you're at.
Pounds of pounds can be yours with Bulko. It's swell to swell. It's grand to expand. It's great to inflate. Red Skeleton, a tooting viewer, stopped tooting and tried Bulko. 2 weeks of the treatment, and he walked into our office and got stuck in the door. So send £200 now for your free sample of Bulko, enclosing your vital statistics and a picture of yourself in suspender belt and silk stockings. Ladies can wear whatever they like. Send to this address, Bulko Special, Kenny Everett, Thames Television, near England. So remember the name, Bulko! If you think I look pleased, it's because I know what's coming next. This next item carries a government health warning. It's a Thames naughty bit. Oh, cripes! Phew, it's the naughtiest bit we've shown yet. It's the naughtiest thing since naught was invented. Ooh, it's tea break time at British Leyland.
There's dancers. When will they stop? And Lenny himself, that skin-tight shirt, hugging his biceps, turning the head of a poor innocent girl. It's got to stop! Pinky! Perky!
remember how, in part one, Captain Kremmen and Carla had just celebrated their last night on the Mud Planet. Afterwards, we sat behind a rock and had a smoke.
Well, that was pretty good, huh, Carla?
Oh, it was magnificent, Captain.
Yeah, it's difficult to improve on perfection, but somehow I always seem to manage it.
Oh, Carla, I've got to give up this brand.
The next day, we eagerly awaited the arrival of the shuttle, which came to collect all the radioactive mud for the Thargoid furnaces to keep the evil swines in power. It arrived on time and landed just near the cave. The door slid open. Out came the guard, pointed his grunge gun at us, and bellowed,
"Load the shuttle, you insignificant, mealy-mouthed scum!"
While the mudmen obeyed the command, Carla whipped out some elastic from her space suspenders.
"Here, Captain."
I plopped a fat, juicy mud pie in it and aimed it at the guard.
"Take this, fiend!"
He reeled back as his big green eyes sizzled in agony.
"I've got his gun, Captain."
"Professor!"
"Yes, Captain."
"Get all the mud men aboard. We're gonna need their help."
"Right away."
Once we'd loaded all the mud men, I took off. As we approached the planet, I had to steer carefully, as all around it were poised atom bombs from Earth, just hanging there, mission uncompleted.
"Oh, Captain, you're so brave and stuff."
"It's nothing, Carla. Hand me a fag, will you?"
"But, Captain, you know what
just
they..."
"Just a slight attack of space nerves."
"No."
"Boy, wait till the Thargoids see what's in the hold."
"Here."
"They'll freak."
"Bowling, there's a great sport. The thrill of cramming your fingers in the holes, picking up that heavy ball, zooming it down the freeway, and watching the skittles scatter. Oh, but don't forget, when you cram your fingers in and fling the ball, don't forget to let go of it, or this will happen."
And now by satellite from the other side of the studio, it's the Rolling Stones.